हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल सेफ्टी ज्ञान। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज ब्लास्ट इन लेबनान। दिस इज द केस स्टडी। टुडे वी विल डू केस स्टडी अबाउट अमोनियम नाइट्रेट एक्सप्लोजन इन बेरूत लेबनान। ड्यूरिंग द केस स्टडी वी विल नो दैट व्हाई दिस एक्सप्लोजन हैपेंड एंड व्हाट वाज द रूट कॉज बिहाइंड इट। On 4th August 2020, at around 18 hours near the Beirut port in Beirut, the capital of Lebanon, 2,700-ton ammonium nitrate exploded in a warehouse. Approx 100 people lost their life and approx 4,000 get injured. The ammonium nitrate was stored in the warehouse since 2013. Today, during the analysis of the incident, we will try to know that the possible root cause of the incident, why it's happened, who was responsible for it. It was not first ammonium nitrate explosion in the world. There are several similar incidents occurred in past. During the case study, such type of few incident will be discussed. But the question is why similar incident took place at different location. What are the reason behind it? Maybe we are not conscious about safety, or we have overconfidence, or we are not getting information about the incident which are occurring in other city or countries, or we are not learning from previous incident. Safety is the part of everyone's life. It is a moral responsibility to everybody to protect people from incident, to protect their life. So that being a safety professional, it may responsibility to share our knowledge through this case study to the people, to make them aware about such type of incident, to create awareness among them, to minimize or eliminate such type of similar incident in future, to save people from injury or fatality. You can see the incident location in this picture. Ammonium nitrate. Ammonium nitrate is a salt of ammonia and nitric acid used widely in fertilizer and explosive. The commercial grade contain about 33.5% nitrogen, all of which is in forms utilizable by plant. It is the most common nitrogenous component of artificial fertilizer. Ammonium nitrate also is employed to modify the detonation rate of other explosives such as ammonium dynamite. Here is the some incident photos. In this picture, you can see firefighting team during firefighting. In this picture, you may see this injured person. Now you can see the incident video, how the explosion was. Now we will discuss about another incident of ammonium explosion which was similar to the incident. Texas City explosion of 1947. Industrial disaster sparked by the fire and explosion of the SS Grant camp on April 16, 1947 in Texas City, Texas. The blast set off a chain of fire as well as a 15-foot tidal wave. 600 people were killed, with as many as 4,000 injured. On the morning of April 16, the French-owned Grand Camp was preparing to finish loading a consignment of ammonium nitrate fertilizer at the port of Texas City. About 8 a.m., crew members noticed a smoke in the cargo area, where 2,300 tons of fertilizer had already been stored. In order to keep the cargo intact, the crew decided not to use water to extinguish the fire. They instead tried unsuccessfully to snuff out of the flame. Shortly after 9 a.m., the temperature inside the cargo area had risen enough to spark a massive explosion that was heard as far as 150 miles away. The resulting fire destroyed the dock area and engulfed the nearby Monsanto Chemical Company plant. A mushroom cloud rose 2,000 feet into the air, and two small planes passing above were destroyed. A nearby ship, the SS High Flyer, which was carrying huge amount of sulfur, also catch fire and exploded, and crude oil tankers near the site burned for day, consuming massive amount of petroleum.
Shortly after 9 o'clock on the morning of April 16, 1947, Texas City, Texas was jarred by a tremendous blast. The French freighter Grand Camp, which was in the harbor and which was loaded with ammonium nitrate, had exploded. The ship had been burning for some time. A large group of sightseers had crowded the area, watching the fire, and those who survived describe it as a beautiful sight, with deep orange smoke rising into the sky, partially clouding the morning sun. This beautiful sight soon turned to one of horror as the explosion split the air, literally destroying the ship and scattering fragments of what remained over a large area. Flashing pieces of metal, white hot from the blast and the tearing, fell on the adjoining Republic refinery, setting oil tanks afire. This tank farm, which was adjacent to the dock area, contained a large number of tanks, part of which contained crude oil, part gasoline, and a few butane. The fire resulting from the ignition of this farm spread over a large area and destroyed a great deal of property. The nearby plant of the Monsanto Chemical Company echoed with an explosion, and fire swiftly spread through the plant. Although the fire did not spread into the town, the explosion caused severe damage to the residential and business sections of the city. Many homes were completely destroyed. Nearly every place of business felt the effects of the blast. Windows were shattered in Galveston, 12 miles across the bay. Buildings were jarred and windows rattled in Port Arthur. The second explosion was even greater than the first. Very little is left of the High Flyer, and the Wilson B. Keene, which was lying beside it, is almost completely gone itself. The strength or the force of the explosion is almost beyond imagination. Fire rages everywhere.
Requirement to store ammonium nitrate. As per OSHA 1910.1091, a guideline for the storage of ammonium nitrate, 1910.1091, subpart 2, second, approval of large quantity storage. 1910.1091 sub part 2 third B storage building shall have adequate ventilation. 1910.1091 sub part 3 second A the temperature of the ammonium nitrate should not exceed 130 degree Fahrenheit. 1910.1091 sub part 4 second B to avoid contamination galvanized iron, copper, lead and zinc shall not be used in a bin construction unless suitably protected. Ammonium bin and wooden bin are permissible. 1910.1091 sub part 7.1 not more than 2500 ton of baggage ammonium nitrate shall be stored in a building or a structure not equipped with an automatic sprinkler system. General cause of ammonium nitrate fire. These root cause are not actual cause of the incident. The investigation is going on. After the final investigation, we will make another video with actual root cause. First, improper storage. Second, no adequate ventilation to a storage building. Third, temperature exceed more than 130 degree Fahrenheit of a storage building. Fourth, flooring of a storage and handling area connected with open drain, trap, tunnel, pit or pockets. Fifth, contamination with other materials. Sixth, galvanized iron, copper, lead and zinc used in a bin construction to store ammonium nitrate. Seventh, more than 2500 ton ammonium nitrate stored in a building or a structure without automatic sprinkler system. 8. Lack of safety system. 9. Lack of safety culture. 10. Deployment of unskilled workmen. 11. Lack of training. 12. Lack of awareness. 13. Lack of competency. 14th, lack of supervision. 15th, lack of SOP, MSDS not communicated or equipment not implemented at site. 16th, electrical short circuit. Cause of ammonium nitrate fire. As per official statement of Lebanon government, the possible root cause are: first, the chemical were stored in a warehouse for 6 years without safety measures. Second, unsecured laying of chemical in warehouse. I hope you like this video and the video helps you to increase or refresh your knowledge about the incident. I hopefully request to you, please subscribe the channel, push the bell icon and comment. If you require training session or video on other safety topic, please comment it. We will arrange the training session or videos on that topic. Please share the videos. Thank you for your watching.